We today we make this Sunday known as children. And all that we are asking the question, we are children.
We are here.
We are here. Praise God. Children are here. Children of the kingdom is here. Children of the Lord is here. We are more than conquerors in Jesus' name. Every day I woke up, and everywhere I go, I realize that I'm not alone. And the question is, what can we do about our children? When the Bible says, train up a child in the way that he should go, and when he gets old, he will go to depart. You know, scripture this evening, it talks about God making promises. And if you abide by these rules and by these illustrations, all will go well. If you disobey anything, you go that way. That's the principle of God. That's what God operates. All right? He is a blessed, merciful, loving, kind God. But he's also a God that has a principle and policy, and he's a God that is just. And the unjust God, as we as children, God has grown in this world, this is how it works. And I'll tell you this is how it works. It works like this. God has given man instructions to look over the world, look over God's creation. God has given man instructions, men as men, okay? Not men as a general, but men. Instruction to look after the family. It just seems that men, that time, today, been reluctant of taking their responsibility, taking care of homes. They're reluctant of being a disciplined father or a disciplined father. I'm talking about men this morning. And instead of being merciful and kind and compassionate and forgiving, they become very abusive. Both to the male sons and female children and daughters. And make it worse. They are more abusive to the spouse or to the woman. So, today, if you look at this today, who is in higher power? So, when we look at these things now, the man leave the woman in charge, and the woman will be happy. Now we find out that the woman, men are abusing women. Now we find out women are more in authority today. The second highest person in the United States is a woman. The highest person who is in power in New York City, in the state of New York, is a woman. And we find out that women are falling into authority and to higher position. What does that mean? It simply means that they will take away man's power away from him, away from man. Let me just put this scenario, children, family, wife. And they will take the power from the man. And who are they going to give the power to? They give the power to the children. They have no knowledge of what's going on, who is innocent about so many things, and now they are in charge. You ever put your hand on me? I'll call the cops on you. Your father is no good for nothing. He's a bum. He's a bastard. He's so many things. And who knows wrong? The woman, so the children create a disrespect to the father. But the thing is this, when we think that we are lowering the men, those who are supposed to be in authority, we also bring down ourselves. The more you think that you're bringing down someone, you're bringing down yourself worse. So now the child is grown, have no respect for the father, no respect for the mother. Which parents, everybody, parents, but I just go in this process, okay? What your parents would have said, respect your dad, you know, or respect your mother. Sometimes the children complain to the parents and talk about the other parents. Oh, mommy did this to me, and oh, Danny did this to me and stuff. And all his buddies like, don't listen to him. Oh, don't listen to who? That's the child. Yes, don't listen to him. So what does that mean? They have no respect for you. They don't listen to you. Even though they're giving good advice, they don't listen to you. Who caused that? Now we are final. That we give the children the authority over the father and over the mother. They give to somebody's hands. They grow up in foster home. They grow up with other family. They grow up in jail or in prison. And they have children with anger, frustration, and so much stuff. And that child grow up with anger and frustration also. Don't know how to handle business. Because they were the one that was taking care of the mother and father when he was 2 years old. So our children are taking so many pressure today, and I always say this, that I am a child of God. In my eyes, children never do anything wrong. What our children need is a little bit more tender love, a little more understanding, a little more caring. What children need, guidance. How to be responsible. And they also need to be disciplined. Whenever you make a mistake, learn from your mistakes. It's not about punishing them all the time, hitting them. You see, there's a difference between punishment and discipline. No, let me clarify that for you. With punishment, you're paying for your deeds. Whatever you have done, you're paying for that. With discipline, you are learning from your mistakes. The more we teach our children how to learn from their mistakes, the more conscious they are of themselves. And the more responsibility they become. They are caring, loving, and they are learning that whenever I violate a law or rule, I will pay the consequence. We teach our children how to respect teachers. What the teacher did to you? This is what I did. This is what I did. Oh yeah? I'm going to the teacher. And tell the teacher, tell the teacher my brain. What you did to my son? What you said to my daughter? That's not the way I don't like that. Don't you ever tell her what to do. And the child is right there, watching everything. And listening. What do you think they want to do to the teacher? When they come out of school, what do you think they're going to do with people in authority? And when they get into jail, or when they get into prison, then who's going to be one crying? Who's the bad person? Now we blame everybody. That this one is bad and bad and that and that. But what have you done? As a mother, as a father, parents. So now, you give the power to the child. Another child, that's what a child is doing. He's giving the power to the dog, to the pets. What the pet? You ever kill or hit a pet or animal? You will go to jail. So the one was authority to pay. So the pets have no authority. Now you're fine. Now. It used to be our time to children, keep the family or the parents together, or the wife and mother, whatever.
So they stay together for the children.
Mm-hmm. Now we are finding out it's not only the children, the other men. Who keep the family together? Cooper. Cooper is a very nice guy, very caring and compassionate. It's the animal and the pet is the one that keeps the wife and the husband is close together. I gotta do this for my pets. I can't go nowhere because of my pet. I gotta stay there because of my pet. I gotta go, oh, I can't go with you, baby. I gotta take care of the pet. That's Cooper. Find out that these things, like me myself, I have a lot of cats. I feel so bad to have a lot of animals. I have cats, I got dogs, I have raccoons. I think I'm with them right now. Who taking care of my pets? One person asked me, so when you're leaving Belize, who will take care of a pet? I said, well, they'll take care of themselves. I found them here. And God is the one that will. God is my man. But what God wants us to do as family, this is not family, Sunday, it's for children. But again, it's the same part of the whole system. What God wants us to do is acknowledge Him. And be more caring for one another. He said, do not provoke your children to anger. To anger. Right. Don't provoke them. But what we did, we provoke them more than anything else. And they become angry and mad. And then when they turn back against us, we are saying disrespectful. You are a very bad child. Rude. So when we think about our children, I really advise the kids right now is have respect for your parents. They love you. They may discipline you for some things wrong with your God, with your, you know, what it is, but it's because of love. And because they care, they want the best for you. They may rail up to you, they may argue with you, and they will force with you, but it's out of love. And for you parents, don't argue with your children. We love to argue with our kids, don't bargain with them. We don't bargain with children. They are part of us. We cooperate. Understand the rules and regulation. If you don't do your homework, you can't work for your child. If you don't do your homework, or if you don't do your choice, you can't go to the movies, or you can't go to the party. So, there's a way, one of these days, teaching kids, teaching parents how to be a parent. But we gotta train them about responsibilities, and their duties, and their accountabilities. That's what our parents have taught us when we were much younger. That's what it was. Before you start playing Nintendo and play your phone and play with TikTok and all this stuff, you finish your homework, then you finish your calling, and then you finish that, you do all this stuff. I remember one day, my son used to go to his mother and told his mother to go out. And his mother said, be careful. And I said, you're sending him out. Next time, you tell him, go talk to the father. So when he called, Mama, go talk to the father. So he comes to me, okay, Dad, can I go? So I said, okay, can I go? Do you finish your homework? Do you clean your room? Do you wash it, you know, take care of your personal hygiene? my God is a loving guy.
Alright.
I'm a father and son. I'm a children. They care, they know their responsibilities. I'm very proud of my son and I tell him my dad, before he turned 25, he was able to own a house. I didn't know how to own a house up to today. And now he's in the Tesla, something I wanted to do when I was a little kid. Make vehicles that have no gas and fast. But now he's working in Tesla and he's also one of the top engineering in that Indian company. And every time my son is getting to some kind of a concern and issues, you have that, you know, this is that, okay, we talk about it. Analyze things, when it was one by house, we analyze that process and how it works. So, Dominic Train is still called, like, he will call his mother and say, Mom, pray for me. You know, this is what I'm going through and this stuff. And, you know, he has that kind of a connection. And he will call his brothers, you know. So, the idea is that not our children will be the way we want them to be. But we got to teach them how to be responsible. When he was a little kid, I make a whole story about kids, because I love them, you know. When my son was like 2 years, from 1 to 2, they still look at it like a mess. He look at me and say, they're good talk, but clean a mess, just do that, okay?
Challenge.
And, every time he clean a mess or whatever he make mess, it's that he don't make more mess than the mess. But the idea that I'm giving him, you will have to be responsible for whatever mistake you made. And he said, many times we as parents, we see our child or children as babies. I don't see my children as babies. I see them as grown adults. Treat them like an adult. Because one day, what is inside of you will come out. You look at a baby today, you're going to be a man, a woman.
Yes, amen.
And if you're not allowed to be responsible now, you will never going to be responsible. You will be underneath mommy dress, try to be protected by them. And then mommy feels so comfortable about my children with me. You're damaging your child, future. You're damaging your generation. You're damaging everybody. So just depending on now, grandma have to take care of this one, and then grandma have to take care of that, and you don't want to take everybody now.
Pastor, I just read an article yesterday with this man paper. Two sons to four. One is 40 and one is 52. Mm-hmm. Kick them out of the house. Problem be, I don't know, let me find out.
But we are here to guide our children. And one thing I love about kids, sometimes they always say, I'm those type of foolishness to these kids or whatever. I drill their mind to be content. I drill their mind to be conscious. I drill their mind so they could think. So they could explore and think about things. What this, what that, what that, how that. Because if they don't exercise their brains, anybody can put anything inside them. They don't have a mind of their own. They're always going to think, mommy, daddy, what this, what that? Now, parents, you have still have control of child when you turn 40 or 50 or 100. You have that power. And that's a matter of need and wisdom to help us, to guide us in that area. You need Bible, you need counseling, you need advice, you will need different things to help you, but never believe that you can live at home. Because this world is about us. And it's our parents, our children. We don't want to harm our children. We don't want our children to be damaged here. Alright? So I encourage you, so let us love and show compassion and teach our children how to respect and how to be responsible for their action and for what they're going to do. And thank you, and God just continue to bless you tremendously all the time. Thank God for the family, thank God for our children, thank God for everybody. And next week is Garifuna Sunday, so we're going to be having TV Ramos service here at our church next week, Sunday, starting at 2 o'clock. Next week, the following week, will be Garifuna Mass. That will be at Ladies of Mercy, I forgot the area, but there will be more information will be given to you. And also, we are looking forward that on the 19th of November, we're going to have a service, a celebration here at church. We call it Indigenous Sunday. So we have another group of church from a different country, Spanish. We always combine celebration here at church. So you're welcome to participate and be a part of us. Next Sunday, our service also will be on Facebook. We're going to be sending Facebook Live. So we will thank God for